Have you ever thought why SpaceX lands its rockets by propulsion, which is extremely hard? Why doesn't SpaceX land its rockets by using parachutes down into water? Well, you'll find out in just a second, but first, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Futurephile, to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. The biggest challenge of returning a first stage is not the landing part from the physics point of view. The biggest challenge is surviving re-entry into atmosphere. Musk compared it with hitting an empty Coke can with a sledgehammer. The terminal velocity of a rocket booster entering Earth's atmosphere is huge. Parachutes cannot stop them. You can use a big airbag in addition to the parachute. This adds another 5% or so to the weight. On paper, the use of parachutes to safely recover space hardware is simple. It requires no fuel, utilizes the dense atmosphere that Earth has, and has a proven track record. However, you have to consider that said parachute, and for a piece of hardware the size of a Falcon 9 booster or Starship's new upcoming booster, it would most likely be parachutes that take up both mass and space, of which is essentially useless for most of the flight, and decrease payload capacity. Parachute landing would also require landing at sea. Salt water plays havoc with spacecraft hardware. As salt water is extremely corrosive and landing in the ocean, even when slowed by parachutes, would destroy the complex parts of the very expensive engines. It significantly increases cost to refurbish, replace and repair if one wants to reuse it. Parachutes only provide drag relative to the air velocity they're moving through, so they are not feasible to get down to zero velocity. Even when steerable, they only have a limited range of action and are still susceptible to unpredictable aerodynamic turbulence. Equipment and material that we do set up to airdrop ends up needing significant preparation and added weight and structure to support it against damage from the landing impact forces. Propulsive landing, on the other hand, gives several advantages. First, the recovery hardware utilizes equipment already on board, i.e. fuel tanks and the rocket engines. Propulsive landing can also be used at speeds much higher than most parachutes can be used at, allowing for the booster to slow itself down at several points on descent. This allows for more mass to be allocated to landing hardware not necessary in parachute recovery, such as the landing legs, which have a combined mass of about 2,000 kilograms. Propulsive landing also greatly helps in pinpoint landing. This greatly decreases cost to reuse, as you can literally fly the boosters to a designated point. Parachutes are not very accurate. It's far easier to hit a spot precisely with a propulsive landing than with a parachute. Another factor in the decision to develop propulsive landing is that you can't land a large vehicle on Mars or Moon with just parachutes. The atmosphere there is much too thin. So the work put into developing propulsive landing for the Falcon 9 easily flows into development for propulsive landing for other spacecraft, most notably Starship. You can't do this with a parachute. When planning to land on airless bodies such as the Moon, parachutes are useless. SpaceX actually tried using parachutes initially. There were several early Falcon 9 boosters which used the engine to gently touch down on the ocean. That's when SpaceX discovered that dropping a Falcon 9 first stage in the ocean destroys it. It's not even a matter of corrosion. The Falcon 9 first stage is fragile enough that just falling over into the water causes it to break into pieces and sink. True, they were already planning to land them on solid surfaces at this point, but it just helped to prove why that was the correct solution and why ocean recover just wasn't going to work. Compared to the parachute splashdown, the propulsive powered landing helps in controlled atmosphere re-entry. It helps in landing precisely where you like, land or sea or Mars. It helps to land at zero speed. It uses less than half the weight of parachutes. Overall, it makes it much easier to make the rockets rapidly reusable in the shortest time and cost. For all these reasons, SpaceX lands their Falcon and Starship rockets not with parachutes, but with propulsion. If you like watching this video, you may also want to watch the video on how big is Starship, shown in the end screen. See you there.